Mark Zuckerberg. Mark Zuckerberg, the CEO and founder of Facebook, was born on May 14, 1984, in White Plains, New York, in a well-educated family. He was one of the four children and the only son of Edward Zuckerberg and Karen. He had three sisters, Randy, Donna, and Ariel. They all grew up in Dobbs Ferry, New York. His father was a dentist and his mother was a psychiatrist. Zuckerberg began his schooling from the Ardsley High School, New York, and later from the Phillips Exeter Academy in New Hampshire. He was an excellent student and exhibited talent for astronomy, mathematics, physics, English classical literature, and foreign languages. Since early age, he began using computers and developed a lifelong interest in programming. While in middle school, his father taught him Atari basic programming. He used it to create a messenger called ZuckNet. Now, Zuckerberg used ZuckNet to connect all the computers between his home and the dental clinic that his father ran. The messenger was installed by his father on his computer in his dental office. This made it easy for the receptionist to inform him of a new patient. The Zuckerberg family also used the messenger to communicate within the house. ZuckNet was considered to be an early version of AOL's Instant Messenger. Along with his friends, Zuckerberg also developed many computer games for fun. To keep up with Zuckerberg's growing interest in computers, his parents hired a programming tutor, David Newman. Newman came to the house once a week and worked with Zuckerberg. He soon realized that Zuckerberg was a genius. At Phillips Exeter Academy, Zuckerberg excelled in literature and earned a diploma in classics. He also exhibited talent in fencing. Yet, he remained fascinated by computers and developed new programs. One such program which he developed was an early version of the music software Pandora, which he named Synapse. The music player was programmed to memorize a listener's music choices. Both Microsoft and AOL were interested in Synapse. They offered Zuckerberg $1 million to buy the software. However, he refused them. They also offered to hire Zuckerberg as a developer, but he politely rejected them and instead enrolled at Harvard University in September 2002. Surprisingly, Zuckerberg refused dozens of such offers from top IT corporations. Although many intellectual people attended Harvard University, Zuckerberg quickly came to be known as a software developer on the campus. By his second year, he developed a program called Course Match. With the help of Course Match, a student could see that how many students had enrolled in a particular course. So, it helped them to find out all the courses other students were taking before making a choice. It also helped students from study groups. Zuckerberg also invented FaceMash, a program to find out the best looking person on the campus. The program allowed the users to compare the pictures and then vote for the most attractive picture. The program became widely popular, but it was soon shut down after it was presumed to be inappropriate. Following his praise on the campus for FaceMash, Zuckerberg, along with his friends, created a social networking site. The site allowed Harvard students to connect with one another. On February 4, 2004, he officially launched the Facebook from his college room and decided to expand it to other schools. Soon, many Harvard students signed up for thefacebook.com. They could now post their photographs and personal information on this social networking site. The popularity of the site and its users increased. What attracted users was that the friends who met in real life now could communicate with one another online. It was something new. The same year, Zuckerberg dropped out of Harvard and relocated to Silicon Valley. Thereupon, Zuckerberg, Moskowitz, and some of his other friends rented a small house in Palo Alto that served as their office. In mid-2004, Zuckerberg met Peter Thiel, who invested in their company. Zuckerberg got his first office. Within a year, the Facebook was opened up to the students of other schools as well. By the end of 2005, the Facebook had reached 5.5 million active users. Zuckerberg kept climbing the ladder of success. By September 26, 2006, any person in the world could sign up on Facebook, as long as he was minimum 13 years old and had a valid email address. Subsequently, the Facebook became Facebook, as it is presently known. Zuckerberg kept the main color of Facebook blue. When asked, he said, "Blue is the richest color for me. I can see all of blue." It is believed that Zuckerberg has a red-green color blindness. The Facebook audience grew rapidly, and the site evolved tremendously. It introduced many new features. The present version of Facebook was introduced in 2010. In 2012, Facebook took over the photo and video sharing social media platform Instagram. 2 years later, the company acquired the famous messaging app WhatsApp. Zuckerberg became the world's youngest billionaire at the age of 24 and the 35th richest American. In an interview, Zuckerberg said, "I have made enough money. At this point, I'm just focused on making sure I do the most possible good with what I have. The main way I can help is through Facebook, giving people the power to share and connecting the world." In 2013, Facebook confirmed that he takes home the salary of $1 per annum. Zuckerberg met his future wife, Priscilla Chan, a biology student at a fraternity party in Harvard. They started dating in 2003, but she went to study medicine at the University of California, San Francisco. In September 2010, Zuckerberg called her back and they moved in together in his rented house in Palo Alto. On May 19, 2012, Zuckerberg and Chan married in Zuckerberg's backyard. At the same time, Chan also completed her graduation from medical school. On December 1, 2015, the couple announced the birth of their daughter, Maxima Chan Zuckerberg. "Max, we love you and feel a great responsibility to leave the world a better place for you and all children," Zuckerberg and Chan wrote in the letter to their daughter. They also pledged to donate 99% of their Facebook shares to promote equality, human potential, and the development of the world. Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.